Those two whistles you just heard tell us that our engineer has received our all clear, and we will be pulling out of the depot at any moment. As we get ready to depart, let me remind you of a couple of the safety rules you'll need to know for our trip today. Please remember to remain seated at all times. This does include small children, as they are not permitted to stand on your lap, on the seat, or on the floor. If you have small children in your group, please have them sit in the center portion of your seat with an adult on the outside edges. Also, remember to keep all body parts inside the car at all times, and the use of tobacco products is not permitted during our trip. Thank you.
Now, folks, while we're on the train ride here, I do need everybody's help. Everybody's got to watch out for the train robbers. We're here. They may be on this train. It's all right, though. They'll be easy to spot. They'll be the ones wearing a mask. All right, everybody. We get going. Everybody push on that row in front of you. Let's help the train get started. Come on, everybody. Push. Keep on pushing. We're not going to get anywhere unless y'all push. There we go. Now that we are moving, y'all on the last couple cars here, wave goodbye to our depot master, Brian. He's up here in the middle of the depot on the left-hand side. Tell Brian we'll see him in about a day or two, a week at the most. But we've never been gone longer than a week. Now here at Dollywood, we're known as a friendly place for the Smokies. Let's go from the train to keep it that way. So we roll out of town on the count of three. Let's give these folks a great big southern howdy. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Howdy! Good job, folks. We'll try that again a little bit later on. Now coming up on your ride here, so Dollywood goes back to your school. It's one of the last operating trips that we're up around today. That's one of that world famous cinnamon bread. If you haven't tried a little cinnamon bread, you definitely need to. I'd get two more than two, but one is not going to make it back to the car. Can y'all just keep on waving and being friendly with everybody? And I'll tell you a little bit about this Rover and keep the history you're riding behind. Howdy, Miss Lillian. In 1938, the Dollywood Locomotive Works in Livingston, Pennsylvania, built our narrow-gauge Macaulay-style engine, number 70. She weighs a little over 230,000 pounds and is a demon, coal-fired, steam-driven, top 2x2 locomotive. That 2x2 wheel configuration simply means she's got two small wheels in the front, eight larger drive wheels in the middle, and two small wheels in the back. After engine number 70 was built, she shipped up to the White Pass Yukon Railroad and was commissioned as a part of the United States Army. Now, December the 7th, 1941, came the attack on Pearl Harbor and U.S. involvement in World War II. After the attack in Hawaii, it was determined that a military highway will be needed to protect Alaska from invasion. So in 1942, the United States Army stole the Wild Pass Yukon Railroad in Skagway, Alaska, and used it to move the materials and the personnel needed to build the outpost military highway. And in December 7th, it was commissioned into the United States Army. 70 veterans off the train with us today. Veterans, raise your hands, everyone. Let's give these folks a round of applause. Thank you for serving our country, and God bless each and every one of you. Now, in 1946, the United States Army left Skagway, Alaska, and the bypass Yukon Railroad was once again a civilian operation. 1870, and the locomotives were now used to haul tourists and commodities instead of troops and building supplies. In 1954, the bypass Yukon Railroad purchased their first diesel locomotive, which was ultimately scoped in for the steam engine. In 1970, it remained in service until 1963, when June retired. And after sitting in storage for 14 years, in 1977, she was sold to the East Tennessee Steam Department in Silverado City, Tennessee. And that's when she officially became known as Cinderella. Now, Cinderella has a name with the two years and the evolution of the car. Oh, there you go. There goes the engineer, Tim Rayland. Cinderella's remaining with us through the evolution of the car. Sure, I'll see you in Tennessee. On to the $38 with which you continue to put additional hard work. Take all this put back in the lap and listen to Cinderella for us up there here now. Keep an eye out for any wildlife you might see out there. You might see a turkey, you might see a bear, you might even see a tiger.
Tune on that Nathan six-chime whistle.
Woo! Woo!
Count of three, let's all tell the engineer to blow that whistle. Ready? One, two, three.
Blow that whistle!
that, everybody. Let's give Engineer Tim and Cinderella a round of applause. That was Engineer Tim and Cinderella saying thank you. Thank you very much. Well, folks, if you look off to your left above the tree line up there across the field, you'll be able to see just a portion of the Great Smoky Mountains National Park. You can understand why the Cherokee called it the place of the Blue Smoke. The Smoky Mountains are the established as a national park back in 1934, and it's the most visited national park in the country, with over 11 million visitors last year. Back to the dawn of the 20th century, there was over 1,200 farms up in these mountains, and each home field was consisting basically the same thing, like what's coming up over here on the left. There was a main house where the family lived, a smokehouse where they hunted to cure their meat, a chicken house where they gathered their eggs, and they also had a spring house. That's where they kept the things like the milk and the butter cold. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. They had one other house back then. It was called the outhouse. Now, kids, do you know what an outhouse is used for? I'm going to let you ask your parents about that one. If they look a little confused, ask your grandparents. They'll know what it was used for. While you're at it, ask them about the woodshed. But if they don't want to tell you about the woodshed, it's probably because the memories are just too painful. We're coming up on the left of the tree, that little green roller coaster down there, that's the Skycase Express. If you go to one of the roller coasters, it goes forward and backwards. Top speed of about 34.5 miles an hour. Don't let 39 inches tall to ride. No loops, no drops, just lots of fast moving curves, which makes it a great family ride. The big blue roller coaster up there, that's the Wild Eagle. It soars 21 stories over the floor of the Smoky Mountains. You'll drop 13 stories right into a 110-foot giant loop that speeds almost 65 miles an hour. How many are drug riders? Raise hands, everybody. Ah, it's not bad. There's a big chicken knocking around the Wild Eagle. There is chicken talk over this train. Down in the Wild Eagle merchandise, y'all can get a t-shirt, right? Yellow t-shirt. And on it, it says, I'm a chicken.
I'm a chicken.
If you're going down the line here, you're going to see Wildwood Grove. It's the newest addition here at Dollywood. It features 11 brand new attractions and experiences for the whole family. Please go check it out. Up there, that's Brad. He's the one responsible for getting us all up here today by hand shoveling all that coal into the firebox. Our engines are operating the same way today as they were on their very first build. On a busy day, Cinderella's going to burn up about 5 tons of coal, pick up about 5,000 gallons of water, as she boils an average of 4,000 to 5,000 people up this mountain today. We're real proud of Cinderella and the guys and gals that operate her. Hope y'all enjoy riding behind them just as much as we do.
I'm gonna go, yeah, and I'm gonna go, 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 and I'm gon
the Dollywood five-time award-winning wooden roller coaster, the Thunderhead. It's also the home of the Mystery Mine. Now that's a steel roller coaster with high speed, wonderful loops, and an 85-foot drop straight down the mine shaft. Okay, then here's your drop line. Now that's 230-foot tower that takes you up in the air and drops you back down at 77 miles an hour. Gotta hit the bathroom before we get on that one.
Remain seated, everyone. We're back, Brian. Remain seated, folks. I'll let you